As winter approaches, it is a time when the forest slows. Many animals enter a state of dormancy, while others continue their search for their next meal as food becomes harder to find. The sounds and the smells in the forest are dampened as the cold takes over. I'm Bennett Twitnell, and this is Grant Caligari. We are videographers with the Hakai Institute. With the use of these stealth cameras, we've been able to capture subtle and intimate moments that we'd never otherwise get to see with our own eyes. And so far, nature has not disappointed.
There's a bear coming through here. Look at the sky.
In an inconspicuous forest halfway up Vancouver Island lies Morrison Creek. We have strategically placed trail cameras throughout the forest, hoping to discover who might still be active during these wet and cold winter months. A bear comes and inspects the camera. Over the winter, bears enter a state of dormancy called torpor, where their heart rate and breathing slows, and they can spend up to 100 days asleep. Cubs during this time don't enter torpor. They spend the time nursing and sleeping. The salmon run in Morrison Creek ends quite late compared to elsewhere on Vancouver Island. Perhaps the bears are still taking advantage of the few remaining fish. On a rainy night, the beaver sits on the edge of its dam. Throughout the year, we have seen many animals use this dam as a crossing point in the forest, like this mink roaming the branches on the beaver's dam. We even get this amazing shot of a cougar inspecting one of the cameras on the dam. Cougars have big, wide paws that help them walk in the snow. This gives them a big advantage over their prey, such as the black-tailed deer whose hooves plunge into the snow. The deer that were once very abundant in the fall don't make an appearance quite as often in the winter. A female cougar heads down the trail, followed by not only one, but two kits who are likely only a few months old. A couple of minutes later, and a male cougar quickly heads down the trail right behind the mother and her kids. Luckily, it seems to head off in a different direction, as males are known to kill cubs that are not their own. A rabbit bounds down the trail. A pine marten, one of the rabbit's predators, follows close behind. Pine marten have dense and warm fur coats, allowing them to stay active throughout the cold months of winter. Perhaps this is the same one we saw scurrying around in the fall. Raccoons are opportunistic omnivores. They have a varied diet and are continually exploring their habitat to find new food sources throughout the year. Spring is around the corner as seen by these robins engaging in fights as winter flocks break up. Pairs want to establish a territory before the spring nesting season. They can spend a lot of time and energy chasing off other robins that migrate through. Bears start to reappear in early March. Adult males emerge first from their dens, females with cubs next. Having survived the winter by living off the fat they accumulated last fall, bears weigh considerably less upon waking. Males will typically drop between 15 and 30% of their body weight, while lactating mothers can lose up to 40%. As the bears emerge from their slumber, they slowly return to their usual dining habits. In the spring, they mainly eat vegetation such as grasses, sedges, and berries. It has been a full year since we first set out our trail cameras with the goal of capturing bears scent marking trees. What we didn't know is how much more we would learn and discover about the inhabitants in the inconspicuous forest that is Morrison Creek.